Here on, we have one triangle and these two sides are equal. And then here, this angle is 14 degrees and this angle is 83 degrees and alpha is asked. Okay. First up, let's call here theta. And then if you take here theta degrees like this, and let's extend this corner, and then let's connect with B point like this. And I want to represent with K this point. Notice that opposite of the thetas are same side, right? Okay. That means BACK is a cyclic quadrilateral, right? Okay. Notice that if here this angle is 83 degrees, that means here this angle must be equal 83 degrees, right? Because of cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, and then notice that these two angles have same side. That means here this angle must be 14 degrees. Okay, for this triangle, we know that sum of the interior angles equals 180 degrees. Therefore, alpha plus theta equal 83 degrees. So here, this angle must be equal 83 degrees. That means we get an isosceles triangle. So AK must be equal KC, right? So these two sides are equal. Okay. And then if you focus on ABK triangle, this triangle and DCK triangle are congruent, right? Because they have same two sides and angles which between these two equal sides. So according to side angle side, these two triangles are congruent. Therefore, we know that congruent triangles have same sides and angles. So if there's a this length opposite of the theta must be equal same length. As a result, we get an isosceles triangle. Therefore, BKD triangle is an isosceles triangle. So BK must be equal KD. Okay, so this angle is also 83 degrees. Notice that for this triangle, we know that sum of the interior angles equals 180 degrees. That means alpha equal 14 degrees. Okay, this was the first method. Now we will calculate value of alpha using second method. Okay, second method. First of all, let's call these equal sides x unit, and then this side let's call y. We know that two interior angles equals one exterior angles. And then for this triangle, if we apply sine rule, x over sine 83 equal y over sine alpha, and then x over y equal sine 83 over sine alpha. Well, this is the first equation. Okay, and then for this triangle, let's apply sine rule again. X over sine 83 plus alpha equal y over sine 40, right? And then x over y equals sine 83 plus alpha over sine 14. Okay, this is the second equation. If we equalize these two equations, sine 83 over sine alpha must be equal sine 83 plus alpha over sine 40. Now you can see easily alpha equal 14 degrees. Thanks for watching. And if you want more videos like this, please subscribe my channel. Bye.